I've investigated about 50 or 60 cases since I came down to New Zealand and Australia. Extremely interesting UFO sightings. A lot of help from local investigatory groups in Sydney and Melbourne. Have found as I go through these that the type of sightings are essentially similar to those in the United States.
What are the main similarities?
Persons of really quite high credibility reporting unconventional objects, discs, cigar-shaped objects, frequently at very low elevation, hovering over sometimes urban areas, sometimes over cars, following cars. Same kind of public reaction, quite a strong similarity to the American reluctance to report them to official channels because of fear of ridicule. But behind it all, a very large number, a very surprisingly large number of these sightings of quite unconventional objects maneuvering in our airspace.
You have been highly critical of your own government's attitude towards UFOs.
Indeed I have, yes. I've taken a very good look at the American official investigation program, Project Blue Book, run by the Air Force, and I have quite unequivocally described it to scientific colleagues back in the States as superficial and incompetent.
Why has the government taken this attitude, in your opinion?
It's not a brief story, but it goes back to 1953 when a CIA-involved investigation was held. As a result of the extremely heavy wave of sightings in 1952, the CIA and Air Force became so concerned over the sheer number of reports that were tying up American intelligence channels that they wanted to get this signal out of the system, asked the Air Force, the CIA asked the Air Force for a debunking policy. The literal wording was to debunk the flying saucers to decrease public interest in the UFOs. Regulations were promulgated very shortly that made it a crime, punishable with, I think it's $10,000 fine and or 10 years in prison to release any information at airbase level on UFOs. And as a result of that, in a sequence of steady downgrading, the whole problem has been essentially lost from scientific sight in the U.S., and nothing resembling any scientific investigation has been going on in the past 15 years.
Has this been typical of the attitude of most world governments?
As nearly as I can tell, yes. There seems to be quite surprising similarity between the official Russian, British, Australian, Canadian, American, French, Italian pronouncements. They all seem to take the view that there's nothing to it, that it's a lot of nonsense, that people see things, and that it is not a real scientific problem at all, and I most heartily disagree with that.
You have been as far as the United Nations with this problem.
Yes, about 2-3 weeks ago, on the 7th of this month, of June, nearly a month ago now, I spoke to the Outer Space Affairs Group in the United Nations, urging immediate UN action on this problem. It seems to me that the UN is one of the best places to tackle the international, the global aspects of the UFO problem, and all evidence now points to its being a truly global phenomenon.
Utant made a statement at the time.
I didn't get to see Utant. That was a busy day, June 7th. In fact, I had a date to see him at 4 o'clock, and if there was any 1 hour that was the peak of the Mideast crisis, 4 o'clock was it. So I unfortunately didn't get to see Utant. But quite recently, a few days ago, I got a wire from a phone call from San Francisco pointing out that he had made a statement to Drew Pearson, an American columnist, that aside from the Vietnamese War, the UFO problem is the greatest international problem. And I sent him a wire, strongly endorsing his position, but disagreeing with him to the extent of saying that I believe it's the most important international problem.
Why?
We have in the UFO problem a very strange situation here. For 20 years plus, essentially similar phenomena have been reported all over the world, large numbers in the U.S., officialdom ignoring them, air forces ignoring them, and yet apparently a steady increase in the numbers of reliable reports from people in all walks of life seeing these objects that are not products of our technology, that are not meteorological astronomical phenomena, hovering at low altitude, increasing numbers in urban areas, and collectively we don't know what's going on. That's an extremely unwise situation, no matter how you view it. We do not know what is involved in this problem. There are no strong indications of anything resembling hostility. I see some faint indications of hazard and danger, but in general, to have this possibility that the world is under something resembling reconnaissance, possibly from some extraterrestrial source, and to go on about our petty ways collectively doesn't seem to me to be a wise situation. So I'm trying to get scientists and governmental agencies to take a look at this at a highly accelerated pace.
Professor McDonald, thank you very much.